Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to the Bogey McSandtrap Career Mode Series here in Rory McIlroy PGA Tour Golf on the Xbox One. So the last time out, we kind of destroyed the course. We've been doing real well in this California Classic. As a matter of fact, we're running away with it. And ultimately, I'm fine with that because I'm just doing this for fun, and you guys seem to like Bogey, but I'm not really too worried about all the difficulty. But I do go in here and take spin control back off because we had that going last time, and I don't think we really need that much help right now. I actually did the swing difficulty to hard as well, so that if you miss on the swing, it'll punish you a little bit more. We also have new clubs available, so I'm going to try out these Cobras and put those in the bags for both drivers and woods, and we're going to head off to the final round of the California Classic. We're 30 under, so not really any danger of losing this thing. Just play a decent round of golf here, show up, and we should be good. So let's go back to the course one more time for the final round, see what Bogey can do finishing this off, and we'll move on to the next event. So arriving at the course here and ready to get going for another round, the final round at the PGA West TPC Stadium course. Let's go to our leaderboard before we tee off today. So Bogey, yeah, 30 under, and Adam Scott's the closest at 12 under. So like I said, show up on the course and things should be good today. So we're swinging these new Cobras, and we'll see how that pays off for us. Like I said, it changed the difficulty, and whoa. Yeah, my swing was a little off there, as you see on the graphic on the left, but he does keep it on the fairway, or does he? Is it going to roll out? Yeah, okay, we're good. We're on the fairway. So we're going to have to be more mindful of our stick control there on our swings, and that one was a good one, as you see, straight and right onto the green. So if we take care of business there, we'll be good. My putting is always an iffy proposition, and right there, he can't make the birdie putt. Didn't read it well enough to sink it, so going to be looking for par on the first hole. Bogey will move on at 30 under and go to the second. On that second hole, he's going to tee off the par 4, and again, should be good on the fairway. That one was much straighter than our first tee shot. Then the result is the same. Stays on the fairway. Going to set up behind that bunker nicely. Second shot now. Approaching the green. Is he approaching too fast? No, it's going to stop right there and be in line for a birdie attempt. Very nice approach, and it looks like it's straight on, and it is. He's able to sink that putt with not very much problem. Didn't have to think too hard about the green conditions there. So he's 31 under, and his second shot on the third. Again, approaching kind of a long, narrow green, and just get on there. Okay, it does eventually end up on the green. We got a ways to go on this birdie putt. 35 feet. Oh my, yes! He sinks it from 35, the long putt. Always feels good when I can actually drain one of those, because I miss medium range ones all the time. So 32 under, fourth hole. This is for birdie. That chip is not going to do it, but it should set him up for a par on this par 3. And left it short. Oh, no. Well, so he's going to give a stroke back here. Not that he doesn't have several to give, or a dozen to give, or a couple dozen to give, something like that. He'll take a bogey, and he's fine. He's just going to drop back to 31 under. Scott at 13. He's hard charging. He's gained a shot, and he's coming. Yeah, okay. I don't think he's going to catch him. This is for eagle. Nice little chip. A little bit off to the right of the cup, and going to roll on past. So birdie putt on the par 5. Yeah, he sinks that. That was pretty straightforward right there. So he'll get that stroke back and go back to 32 under. 20 ahead of Scott. Seventh now is the hole that we're on. Second shot of the par 4. Oh, beautiful approach right there onto the green. Sticks it close to the cup. And he's fired up. So his birdie putt has got a little bit of a curve to it, but he's able to sink that. Okay. Big exhale every time I'm able to do one of those with some break on it. 33 under now. And I don't think he's going to get anywhere near his 14 under round that he had in the third round, but just play solid. This is for eagle. No, not going to make that. But again, he'll have a realistic birdie attempt. Putt coming up. And a bit of a break on it. Yeah, okay, he sinks that one. So I'm having some pretty decent luck putting so far by my standards. 34 under as we're getting close to getting to the back nine. First, we're going to attack the ninth hole, par four. See where we can drive. Oh, okay, this was by far his worst drive of the day, you see. I didn't do so well on the stick there. So I'm usually pretty good these days at getting it straight. Not that one. We're in the heavy rough over here, trying to also avoid this tree that might come into play. Oh, nice recovery, though, right back in the middle of the green. So maybe we can save par on this thing. Third shot. Get it on the green. Get it there. Get there. Is it short? Oh, it's going to get just on the edge of the green. Let's see if he can recover and par this sucker. The putt. Oh, no. Just a little bit to the right. So he's not going to get the par after saving himself from the rough. He's going to tap in for bogey and drop down to 33 under. Oh, no. He's 33 under. Whatever shall he do? Yeah, he's just fine. He's going to win this tournament. Running away still, no matter what he does. He can bogey the rest of the holes. He can hit a few in the drink if he wanted to play around, but yeah, he's not going to do that, I hope. This one to the green on his third shot, the par five. He's on, and he's looking good. Birdie attempt to make back that stroke he lost. Can he get it? We got some break to deal with. No, didn't compensate correctly there either. Going to miss the birdie putt. He's a little broken up about it, but he'll be okay. Going to tap in for par and realize he's about to easily win this tournament, so he should have no fear about that. So 33 under. And we now go, what hole are we going to check out next? We're going to go to the 13th. So teeing off on the par 3, 13th. Get it over the water. Ooh, okay, that one was off to the right a little bit too. See a little bit of hiccup in my swing there. And going to cost us, as it put it, in the rough. Now a chip for birdie. Sometimes I can hole out on those. Not this time. Going to look for another par, which he does get right there. So staying at 33 under through the 13th hole. Let's move on to further play. I think we're going to pick it up on the 14th. Yeah, very next hole. Second shot. Over the bunker and through the woods and to grandmother's house we go. Well, not unless grandmother lives on a golf green, which I don't think is the case. Okay, I'm getting a little silly here. But birdie attempt, and he gets it. Yes. That was not silly at all. That was a quality putt. And he's now 34 under once again. The rest of the field just battling for second place there, all 11 under. At least four golfers tied for second place money. But we want that first place money, and oh my. He almost eagles right there. Beautiful approach. If he misses this, I would be shocked. He'd have to try hard to miss this. The tap in for birdie, and he's now 35 under. 5 under on the round. As we move to the 17th, I think we got the 17th coming up. Beautiful water shots right here. Ah, I love all the course shots. They're so cool. All the scenery around here. You know what's even cooler is making sure we keep this ball on the island green on 17. Don't want to hit any water. Although, like I said, kind of make it interesting. You could try to skip one over there. See if you could skip it like a rock onto the green. You know, experiment a little bit since you got so many shots to play with. And, well, he's going to give up his birdie putt there. That one should have been sunk, but it wasn't. Whoa, did a fish just jump behind him? Did you see that splash? I actually looked back on the footage. I'm like, could you see something jump there? You could just see the splash. Anyway, there is the par that's going to send him to the 18th, 35 under. And here to finish off the tournament on 18, second shot. He's just waiting to get in that clubhouse and see what kind of nice adult beverage he can find himself after this to celebrate. Nice tall cold one or two or three maybe. And celebrate a win. But how about this birdie putt? No, he can't end off on a high note. He'll par the thing. Yeah, look at how broken up he is. I mean, come on, dude. You're 35 under. You're just fine, Bogey. Go make the putt and win the tournament. There you go. He wins the California Classic. And it's not even close. 35 under is the final.
couldn't agree more, Rich.
Score for him as he's 5-under today. So we took that spin off and made the difficulty on the shots a little bit harder. And I don't know. I think if we had it the whole tournament like that, he probably still wins. I don't know. But he is your California Classic winner. Bogey McSantrept is a sensation. He's tearing up the PGA Tour. And there's official word that he's playing Cobra now, although we already started that. So another tournament in the books. Coming up is the Tiburon Championship. What does that replace? Is that like the Masters or one of those? I can't remember which one replaces which. Anyway, we'll see you next time for more Bogey McSantrap. Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com is a place. All summer long, I'm partnering with FanDuel to bring you some fun daily fantasy sports action. Go to FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse and use the promo code SGU to get a free entry into a 50-50 league. That's FanDuel.com/SportsGamingUniverse.